Talks.
Hello there, and welcome to this short video on contact center intelligence. My name is Andrew Kane, and I'm a principal solutions architect in the worldwide AI/ML specialist organization. Today, we're going to focus on how generative AI can add an additional value to an existing AI-driven contact center. So we're going to start really by talking about contact center intelligence. So every customer actually wants this, but it sometimes can be difficult to actually understand why someone needs to have this. There are many, many reasons usually, but we're going to touch on really the major three areas here in these next few minutes. So AWS Contact Center Intelligence, or CCI, they really helps to address three main contact center use cases, which we'll talk about briefly now. And customers can choose to start to implement any one of these by themselves and then move to the others if they actually need them later on. So Agent Assist, this really makes use of real-time transcriptions, natural language processing, and translation. Agent Assist is there to really give agents real-time suggestions using enterprise search tooling to pull information from knowledge bases and other data sources to answer the question that the customer has just asked on the line. So if they actually ask, what's the interest rate on this account, or what's the best three products for me given my situation, the Agent Assist system should prompt back to the agent exactly what to say next. The call analytics, one can do this actually in real time or post-call. With real-time analytics, of course, the solutions can give you live customer conversation transcripts and really help the agent understand the context of that call and give them essentially live notes to scroll up through the transcript to work out what was just said a second ago without asking, can you repeat that? The post-call solution is slightly different in that it works on offline audio. The call has actually finished by this point. But between the two of them, they're both there to give you a lot of natural language processing skills to actually go through 100% of your customer conversations. So this really gives you real strong coverage of all the engagements that you've had with all of your customers across your entire contact center, giving you great insights into like emerging trends, the customer sentiments, what common call drivers actually are. And it can also help identify customer service and business opportunities to actually improve. And with those insights, you can really better understand your customer base and derive better solutions to help solve their problems. And the side effect of this is also that you can use analytics to work out and assess your agent's performance and actually monitor their compliance to your various scripts that you have designed and developed. The self-service is quite a quick one for this conversation. It really uses speech recognition and natural language understanding to build conversational chatbots or IVR systems. It really helps deflect calls from those human agents by allowing customers to actually find answers to their problems and to their concerns on their own without actually the assistance of a live agent. And they're also really good because they can also identify the intent of the particular caller. And if for some reason they can't fulfill their needs online, when it gets routed to an actual live agent, that agent has got all the context that's gone before as part of the chatbot. So they know all about the customer who's called, and they don't have to ask the same things over and over again. So how can generative AI or GenAI actually make this better? Well, let's look at what our CCI solutions can currently do on the left-hand column. We can find out the intent of a call, track the sentiment, look at how compliant the agent is with their scripts, and things like that. But that's really just using ML models that are looking at the transcript, essentially line by line. This is still really powerful, and I'll give some examples of that shortly in the live demo. But such ML models will suffer from one obvious problem, which is the quality of the utterances from the callers. So as you probably know, people don't often quite say what they mean. Or they talk about the problems in a rather roundabout way that becomes quite difficult for the agent to actually understand. Of course, they get there in the end. But an ML model that's trained to look for the major issue in a call may struggle to give much more context other than the transcript line that actually calls it out. Now, that in itself, of course, is very useful. But with GenAI, using the power of something called large language models, or LLMs, this allows you to generate far higher quality outputs that can feed downstream systems. LLMs can also answer much more abstract queries, such as, how did the call go? This is really obvious or really apparent in the transcript, but LLMs are able to look at the whole conversation in the round and actually tell you what the call outcome actually was. So before we go any further, we'll look at some of the architectures and other benefits before we head into the GenAI demo. So the architectures we have for the live call and post-call solutions are actually quite similar. We're going to go through them now really at a very high level. There are some other details that we're just going to gloss over, but they're both open source solutions, and you can find full architecture diagrams online just by searching for AWS Live Call Analytics or Post-Call Analytics. A live call at this very heart, it really takes in an active customer with a live call. Now, this audio will then stream into something called the Amazon Chime Voice Connector, which picks up the audio and routes it to Amazon Kinesis video streams, so it's chunk by chunk. A Lambda function will then pick up that audio and pass it on to Amazon Transcribe to create the transcripts, which will in turn call Amazon Comprehend and any other ML models it needs to generate the metadata that you want in your output. Post-call, conceptually, is very, very similar. Rather than a live call audio stream, we actually just have an audio file that we drop into an Amazon S3 bucket, which is picked up by a similar Lambda function, which then does exactly the same orchestration by sending the audio to transcribe, which then calls comprehend, and so on. The one major difference, though, really, is apart from the live aspect, is when you have live call, you're able to do something called agent assist. And that's where transcribe's line-by-line output will be sent to Amazon Lex and Amazon Kendra to act as your enterprise data store and try and find the answers to your customers' questions in real time. And once that's done in the live call solution, the agent should see it on screen and should be able to solve the customer's problem much faster. But this is what we have now. We've had this for many, many months in one form or another. This has been around for like 18 months or longer. But really, we're now starting to add generative AI solutions to the mix. And what we're doing in all the solutions is we're giving you an option as a customer to deploy different types of generative AI model within the application as you see fit. We're not trying to restrict you to just one or the other. You could use Amazon SageMaker or Amazon SageMaker Jumpstart and use any of the models that you've built and deployed in your SageMaker environment. You could also use just Lambda. And the system will then call it to Lambda, so you can call it to any other third-party model system that exists. So if you want to call one that you've built internally in your data centers, that's absolutely fine. Call a third-party one run by a different vendor, it's absolutely fine. Lambda will let you do that and act as that conduit. But at the bottom, we're quite excited to say we can now use something called Amazon Bedrock, which is our now in private beta generative AI managed service, which allows you to do exactly the same thing. So all of these solutions can basically take that transcript and put it through GenAI to give you additional insights. So you can see what the additional insights actually are. This is what you get before GenAI. You can see that you get termination transcripts, you get to redact sensitive data, etc. And there's a few obvious outcomes on the right-hand side. And this is what we've had in these solutions for a good 18 months or so. But when we add in generative AI to the mix, the left-hand side is now just showing you a view of all the standard benefits from an AI-driven contact center, but we can now augment them. By adding LLMs or foundation models, we can take the data that the CSI solutions have already generated. So the transcripts, the entity that have been detected, sentiment trends, and use them as inputs to the LLMs. So we can now augment the Q&A feature provided by Lex and Kendra using LLMs. We can also provide very high quality call summaries that really negate the need for agents to fill out their standard post-call wrap-up forms. And the same goes for call outcomes. The LLM will tell you what the outcome actually was. The agent doesn't have to work it out by themselves by scanning through the AI-generated transcript for all the pertinent details. They just haven't got the time. So these things are all just generated automatically. And the overall experience for the agent and the customer is pretty much improved. So we've now just switched across to our demo of our open source solution for post-call analytics. Now, some of you may be familiar with it. But we have recently revamped the UI and added some new features to allow the generation of two additional sections of metadata that were created using generative AI techniques. So on screen, you can see the new front page UI of our post-call analytics solution. Now, at its heart, it really is just trying to list all the calls that we have actually gotten into our contact center. And they're listed basically by the file name of the audio file that your telephony system has sent us. Now, most systems can call them anything you like. They can put the timestamp into the call, the name of the agent into the file name, all sorts of different things. But it doesn't really matter for the function of the system. It's just there as a reference point to say you can map this back to a particular telephone call. And we give you things like a timestamp of the call, the customer sentiment, of course, as a single marker of a happy face or a sad face. And actually, what's more important is the trend of the call. With this fifth one, of course, you can see the customer is unhappy. But actually, on average, unhappy on average, but you can see that the trend got better. So although they may have been unhappy at the start of the call, they're in a better place at the end. Whereas the one above is the complete opposite. They left happy, but they perhaps haven't left the call as happy as when they began. So these pieces of metadata are all very useful. So let's just click into one of the calls. And if you've seen this application before, you'll recognize some of these fields. And that we start off by basically giving you some metadata about the call as a whole on the left-hand side. So we can see things like, what was the language of the call that was recorded, what was the agent sentiment and the customer sentiment, of course. And then they give you information about the actual audio file itself. So what format was the file? Was it a WAV file? Was it an MP3 file? What was the sample rate? 8 kilohertz, 16 kilohertz, etc. And which of the additional features of transcribe you've actually turned on? In this case, we have turned on PI reduction, but we haven't used a custom vocabulary or a vocabulary filter because we didn't feel the need for these particular files. And the first thing to pick out of AI, and there's a lot more features, but I'll just pick on one or two, is the sentiment trending of the conversation. So you can see really on a quarter by quarter basis of the call, what is the sentiment score between +5 and -5 for each of the participants? As you can see here that the customer started off 0, completely neutral, and it got slightly better. And over the course of the call, it really went up to 3.3 or even 3.6 in the end, which really makes you think that the agent did a good job. They resolved the person's problems and everything was actually good for them. And you can see below the amount of speaker time across the conversation. Now you'd expect your agent to speak maybe half the time, a bit more than half the time. It all really all depends on the context. But this lets you see quite quickly who is just talking far too much. And one thing we can also see on the graphs is we have information such as like the decibel scoring of each of the speakers and participants. But we'll skip over some of this today for the sake of time, because what we really want to see are these middle two panels. So on the right-hand side, we've looked at the transcribe, the extractive ML models that they have to work out what was the issue for the call. Why did this person actually call in? And it's quite true. This is completely correct. They called in because they said they were at a particular boating terminal trying to dock their ship, and they dropped their card into the water and they wanted it replaced. And the outcome of the call was actually what you'd expect too. The agent has said they've got the card cancelled. They're going to send it on to a redacted address, and they've emailed a confirmation. But this information is all really useful. And if you scan through the transcript, you can read it all in more detail if you want to. But on the left-hand side shows you the GenAI versions of some of these things. The first part is really, it's gone through everything and it's summarized the entire conversation and its main important points. Now, the agent has done nothing here. It has just gone through and it's quite clearly called out. This customer was called in to report the lost credit card, reported why, that the agent verified the identity, and the new card was sent out. But I also picked out on the fact that multiple addresses are mentioned in this call, and it wasn't sent to any of them. The card was sent to a PO box number because that's what the customer said to do. What's also quite important on this, and is actually quite interesting, is they also called in to change the pronouns that the organization held for the customer on the system. Now, the agent did this quite happily. One thing we found out, of course, is that during the course of the conversation, the customer never actually said the word identity, because they just asked to change their pronouns. But because of the nature of LLMs and the way they can look at conversations in their rounds and take information from what's not actually in the transcript, the LLM worked out that the reason they were actually doing this was to change the way that their identity was reflected in the system, even though the customer never actually said it. And this really shows a really powerful aspect of what GenAI can actually do. It can take perhaps the conversation transcript, which is not as well spoken as it perhaps could be, and turns it into something that you could just read and really easily understand. And the call outcome, again, it's a bit more detailed than just what the agent said in this one transcript line to say the card is cancelled. It just goes through to share a bit more detail that there was many things actually happened on this call, that the card was cancelled, replacement issued, sent, and customer info was updated. So with GenAI, you can actually really take this transcript and generate something that's much more useful, much more intelligible, and is much more powerful to put into your BI reporting tools when you're looking for calls of particular things in, looking for particular call outcomes, etc. It's much better than just having the transcript line where you hope the customer and the agent has said the right thing at the right time. With GenAI, it's all smoothed out, becomes much more powerful and much more understandable to the end user. So I hope that was a quick but informative session on how generative AI techniques can further augment an AI-driven contact center, giving you information automatically that just wasn't easily attainable before the advent of GenAI. Now, these are just our first two queries in the post-call solution, and we're going to be augmenting these in the near future with many more possibilities for customers to put in more and more queries on those call transcripts. So thank you for listening. My contact details are on the screen if you wish to reach out with any questions, or just contact your AWS account team if you wish to dive deeper into this topic. And thank you again for your time.